and welcome to the future. This wonderful city has been in peril for many years.
Venice is still sinking, but it's also fighting an increasing battle with the water that surrounds it.
We begin our journey into its future by taking a ride on a new boat that's devouring one of the city's biggest enemies, its waves. They call Venice the Silent City. No roads or cars. A peaceful haven for gondolas gliding through the canals, creating barely a ripple. But these days, gondolas are a photo opportunity for tourists rather than a serious mode of transport.
Now the people who live in the city want to get around faster. So today, Venice's main transport is on motorboats. These come in all shapes and sizes and dominate the waterways.
But this is creating a new problem. The waves that the motorboats make as they plough through the water are pounding against the walls of the canals, destroying the buildings' foundations. The houses are crumbling, the palaces disintegrating.
Pollution is also rising as the water buses, known as vaporettos, pump out diesel fumes. The city has introduced a new vaporetto that combines battery and diesel power to combat this, and its slimmer hull design produces less waves. But escalating traffic means the erosion problem is still getting worse.
Now a new type of boat has appeared on Venice's troubled waters that just could provide an answer.
This boat has been developed especially for Venice with a brand new hull design. Compared with an ordinary motorboat, waves are greatly reduced.
Here's a usual water taxi. The water is forced to the sides of the boat as it moves along, creating what's known as a bow wave. Now look at the boat I'm on, and you'll see there's hardly any bow wave. The water is being sucked inside the hull, so the boat is literally eating the waves.
The wave-eating boat is the brainchild of Charles Robinson, an American with a passion for Venice and determined to solve the problem of its crumbling walls.
So, Charles, how does it work exactly?
Well, those two skirts outside of the central hull recapture the bow wave. The bow wave spirals through the channels, those two channels you can see there, and as the ceiling of those channels come down to the waterline, it compresses the air. So we are planing on an air cushion, which makes it much more efficient than a conventional boat, and we suppress the wave.
The shape of the hull acts like a funnel, forcing the spiraling mixture of air and water along the length of the boat. As the space in the funnel reduces, the air is compressed and the boat is lifted on a pocket of air. Although there is a wake when the water finally emerges from the stern, most of its energy has been used up, so it hits the buildings with much less force. And because the boat is planing on air, it goes faster.
But just how fast? Well, to test it out, we've got the boats lined up, one behind the other, and in turn, they're going to steam past the edge of this wall. And to test the action of their waves against the wall, I've got a stack of lovely pictures of Venice. So the question is, how wet will they get? First up, travelling at top speed, is an ordinary vaporetto.
I think I might be having a rethink. Absolutely soaking.
Next to go is a standard water taxi.
Oh! That nearly got me that time. Definitely damp.
And now here comes Peter on the new waveless boat.
Barely a splash, that's it. Still dry.
Venice's transport leaders are so impressed by this prototype that they've commissioned a much larger boat with the same hull design. It's on its way from San Diego now and will be used to ferry people from the airport on the mainland across the lagoon to the island of Venice.